Find this and other great figures at BigBadToyStore.com.
What's going on, guys? Today we are taking a look at the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Shogun Megazord. This is one of my favorite Megazords ever, simply because he is absolutely bananas and, well, I mean, look, you've got five different big robots that get knocked over very easily, and they all combine into one very much larger robot. Each one of these guys is kind of modeled after the Ninja Megazords. So we've got Blue Wolf, Red Crane, Pink Crane, Red Ape, Yellow Bear, and Green Frog. And each one of these Shogun Megazords comes with their own weapon. Black has a bow, Yellow has a claw, or it says Ninja Spear, but it's really a claw. Blue has a lance, Red has daggers, but they're really knives. Pink has daggers, but they're really knives. And Red has this shield. So these guys are not utilized the same way in the American show as they were in the Japanese version. In the Japanese version, they use their weapons a lot more. They also use the battle modes a lot more. And it's definitely different. In the US version, the Alien Rangers used the BattleBot modes, and then the Earth Rangers kind of used these. It got a little weird there in the third season. But overall, each one of these figures looks really nice. So let's go ahead and take a little bit of a closer look at them. Let me tell you, getting these guys on my little turntable was not an easy task. Here we have Red, and Red is a very interesting look to it. I just really like it. It looks like a house. In fact, all of them kind of look like they have a house on their chest. And that just has to do with the way the Japanese lore and the series work as a whole. Because apparently they all make up this giant castle in Japan, or this giant ancient castle, or they're parts of it, and then they all merge into the robot version of that ancient castle, which is the Megazord. It's weird. It's Japan. What do you expect? Overall, though, I think individually each one of these guys looks really, really cool. And they all have a unique feel to them. They're all decorated differently, and they all just are interesting, dare I say. So, enough taking a look at the guys individually, let's go ahead and get them combined. Black and Yellow are going to form the legs, and they have the same transformation. Start off with, open up their back, fold up their arms, and then collapse them into the back and fold the back up, and then collapse their legs down so they form lower legs, like that. Same thing on Yellow, open the back up, fold the arms in, collapse the back again, and then collapse the legs down so they form Daleks. Pink and Blue are up next. They have the same transformations. Fold up the arms over the heads and then collapse the arms down, and then fold the feet up to reveal giant robot fists. Do the same thing for Pink. Fold up the arms and then collapse them down into the body. Fold up the legs, giant robot fist. Finally, we have Red. So pull the arms out away from the body, fold the back open and flip the arms inside, and then flip the back up again. Take the crotch plate and fold that up over his chest, and then the legs will fold, the feet will fold up and over the hip skirts. Like so. Like that. Now for the combo. Fold out these connector clips, and then they will connect on top of Yellow and Black, like so. And then we'll attach Blue, and we'll attach Pink, and then take the Crane Battle Helmet, fold the Megazord face down, fold the wings up, drop the helmet on top, and then fold the wings out to attach them into place. And it really doesn't work all that well all the time. And here we have the Shogun Megazord. Again, one of my all-time favorite Megazords. He just looks so cool. He's big, he's burly, and he looks like he's ready to just punch someone into non-existence. Just one of my favorites. He also comes with this giant fish sword that breathes fire, but you wouldn't be able to tell based on the fact that the plastic is, well, crap. And thankfully, my sword doesn't seem to be suffering from gold plastic syndrome, but that is a problem with that specific sword. Overall, he's a fantastic Megazord. The only real problem I have with him is his head. That crane helmet doesn't like to stay on at all. And if you also notice, he is a little bit on the heavy side for one of the original Megazords because my turntable doesn't appear to appreciate it. He has a limited poseability. He can move his arms and that's it, but that's enough. When you're this big and you look this beefy, you really don't have to move all that much. The last thing we're going to do with the Shogun Megazord is attach the White Falcon Zord to him. To do that, first remove blue and pink. And you see these connector clips? That is where the Falcon Zord will plug in. Take your Falcon Zord and make sure he is straight with his feet pointing straight down, or as down as they'll go, like that. Then he doesn't clip onto the back, but rather he kind of hugs the Shogun Megazord. So hug the Shogun Megazord and clip the wings into place, fix the head, and then clip pink and blue back on. And then fix the head again. And here we have Shogun Megazord, Deathbird mode! Okay, maybe not Deathbird mode, but he is really cool. I mean, just, you have a giant bird with missile firing capabilities sticking out of you. That is just awesome. I absolutely love this configuration. It's just nearly perfect in my eyes. It just looks badass and ready to really start something, or in this case, end something in an explosive manner. So I hope you enjoyed this video review of the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Shogun Zord with a little bit of help from the Falcon Zord. I'm Bolt Matrix, and as usual, I'll catch you next time.